Yo, check out this TikTok video. Just saw it recently and I thought about recreating it in After Effects, cause why not? And here's what I got. Pretty cool, isn't it? Let me show you how I did it. So before starting the video, I just want to say that in order to create this project, I used the Sapphire plugin, and if you don't have it, you can't follow along with me, but if you want, I can drop a link with a free trial of the plugin, so if you need it, just leave a comment below and I'll drop the link. Alright, so first of all, let's start by creating a new composition, call it Ocean Waves, and 9020 by 1080, 24 fps, 15 seconds, press OK. Now let's drag this image as a reference, maybe scale it down a little bit, something like this, and let's lock the layer just so we don't move it by accident. Now let's create a new rectangular shape, double click on this, we don't want any stroke, and now let's take again the rectangular tool, make sure this time you have the mask selected. And let's just drag a big mask here, about 2/3 of the composition. Now let's call it wave. Alright, now let's apply a texture micro effect. This one from Sapphire Render. And for the frequency, I'm going to create a keyframe. Press U to reveal the keyframe. And for the start, I'm going to make it 65. And let's say here, after about 10 seconds, let's make it 100. Now hold Alt and click on the stopwatch. And let's loop this animation with the loop out expression and with the continue modifier. All right. Now for the frequency rel X, we're going to change this to 0.1. Now for the color one, let's change this to B23D24, just to give it that red color. And for the color 0, let's make it 090B20. Next step, let's add a warp corner pin, again from Sapphire. And let's just move these points, first one here, second one, the third one here, and the fourth one here at the end. Actually, I've already noted the exact points, so I'm just gonna write them here. Now for the wrap X, just choose reflect, and in this way our texture will be reflected on the entire composition. Actually, let's take this image and just move it above the wave, so we can see what we're doing. Now let's add a turbulent displace effect. And for the displacement, turbulent is fine. For the amount, let's make it 20, and for the size, about 48. You can change it depending on how fast you want the waves to move or how turbulent, better said. For the complexity, let's increase this to about 5. And for the evolution, let's put a keyframe. Press U again. And let's write here time multiplied by 50. And now we have this texture that looks like a sea with some red waves moving along. So we're done with this composition and now let's create another. So let's create a new composition. Same settings as before, let's call it Ocean. And let's drag the Ocean Waves composition here. Now let's create a new shape with the rectangle tool, double click on it. And let's just rename it to Sky. Let's now take again the rectangle tool, make sure you have the mask button selected and just draw a big mask about 1/3 of the composition, just enough to cover that black space. Let's also change its color, let's say CB3822. Now duplicate this sky layer with Ctrl D, rename it to clouds, and for that press M to select the mask and just move the mask a little bit higher, something like this. Now let's search for the S clouds effect. Again, it's from Sapphire Render. For this, let's increase the frequency to about 6.8, and for the speed shift X, let's make it about 60. For the color 1, let's change it to 412A2B, and for the color 0, let's make it A92107, something like this. Now let's press F to reveal the mask feather, and let's increase the mask feather to about 130, maybe more, 140, yeah, something like this. Alright, now let's take the ellipse tool, and in the middle of the composition, let's just create a big circle for the sun, something like this. Let's also change its color, make it FFFDE1. Decrease the opacity to about 80%. Maybe make it a little bit smaller. Alright, let's rename the layer to Sun Center. Now let's create a new shape with the rectangular tool. Double click on it. Let's rename it to Sun Glow. For the color, let's make it to FFBD20, press OK, press F for the feather. Actually, we have to create the mask before we can add the feather, so for this, take the ellipse tool, make sure you have this tool create mask selected, disable the layer and just draw a big mask around the sun. Now enable the layer again, press F, change it to about 160, maybe 150, yeah, that's better. Now let's add some turbulent displace effect. For the amount, make it 40, for the size, only 2. We only want to have a little bit of movement, just a little bit. So for the evolution, make a keyframe, press U, and let's write time multiply by 400. Change the opacity to about 85 and we're good to go. Maybe we can make the sky a little bit larger, so take the mask and just drag it a little bit lower, something like this, and also the mask for the clouds, yeah, something like this. Take the sun, drag it, actually only the sun center, drag it a little bit lower, and the sun glow, take the mask, again drag it around the sun. And for the mask of the sky, let's increase the feather to about 15, yeah, that's fine, but maybe 13 would be better. Alright, now let's create a new shape with the rectangular tool. Let's call it Sun Fog. Let's move it before the sun center layer. Also change its color to ECBD49 and disable the layer. Take the pen tool, make sure you have this tool creates mask button selected, and let's just draw a random mask around the sun. Alright, something like this. Now take the mask and make it a little bit smaller. Yeah, that's fine. Maybe invert it. Yeah, much better. Enable the layer again. For the feather, increase it to about 30. Change the mode to classic color dodge. Change the opacity to about 40. And let's add the turbulent displace effect. For the amount, about 15, 78 for the size, and increase the complexity to about 10. And for the evolution, click on the stopwatch, and again write time multiply by 50. Yeah, it's pretty weird, those lines, so maybe we should delete some points from the mask. I don't pretty much like this. Yeah, that's much better. Alright, now let's create a new shape again. Move it before the sun center, actually before the sun fog. Disable the layer, call it sun water reflection. Again, change its mode to classic color dodge. And what you have to do now is take the pen tool, make sure again you have the mask selected, and let's just drag a big trail here, which is gonna be the glow and the reflection that the sun has on the waves. Alright, now enable again the layer, press F for the feather and increase this to about 65, add a turbulent displace effect, make it 15 and 78. For the complexity, again increase it to 10, and for the evolution, make a keyframe. And again, just write, as you already know, time multiply by 50. Now let's add the curves effect. And let's create a little bit of contrast. Maybe let's fade it some more, just so it will blend a little bit better within the water. Yeah, something like this. And maybe we can twitch a little bit the red color. Yeah, seems pretty good. Actually, this is pretty much all, but let's now make the final adjustments. Let's create a new adjustment layer, call it grain. Let's add a grain effect. I'm going to use the S-grain effect from the Sapphire again, but you can also use some simple grain. And I'm just going to increase the frequency to about 600. Yeah, that's fine. If you change this to full resolution, it looks entirely different. You can see there are so many details around the waves, but my computer can't handle it, so I'm going to switch it back to third. Alright, let's now create a new adjustment layer and call it curves. Let's add some curves, obviously. And let's create a little bit of contrast. Something like this. Let's change the red one a little bit. Okay, something like this. Now this is pretty much static, so let's also fake a little 3D camera movement. For this, let's create a final composition, add the ocean composition here, and just search for wiggle position effect. For the speed, I'm going to make it 0.3, and for the pixels, just 20, that's fine. Now let's increase the size, because we now have this black space, so to about 105, that's pretty much enough, and let's see how it looks now. Actually, before that, we can take a sad song and let's search for a part where the song blends a little bit better with the scene. Yeah, this one, when the end fades, we're going to use this part. Okay, and now let's see how it looks. So this is the final result. Thanks a lot for watching. Make sure you leave a like or a subscribe. It would mean a lot to me. And talk to you soon. Bye.